Hello everybody, welcome back to today's video. We are on MX Bikes today and we have a brand new soundtrack being released by TC, aka Typical Canadian. The track is just called TC's Private Soundtrack. A little bit of a orangey kind of whitish sand with the just home practice track vibe, you know, not much going on, just kind of empty pit surrounded by trees, almost like a little bit of a like a just a secluded area. So you can just go and pound some laps out in the sand and really hone your craft. This track seems to have come out at an absolutely perfect time for us MX Bikes players. We have got the AMA round of Southwick coming up very shortly on Friday. So it gives us a little bit of time to practice the sand a bit, work on some suspensions, get an overall feel of it, working with the traction and the bumps, etc. And I'm very, very excited to see what it entails. I have only played one other soundtrack by TC in the past, which I really, really enjoyed. And even that back then wasn't a full-fledged soundtrack. It was kind of almost like an afterthought of a main arena cross track. The general consensus looking at MXB mods is that people do really enjoy this. The only issue that I've seen someone say is a few more ruts in the turns. But looking at this track preview right now as we fly around, it looks to be more than enough. You know, at least two lines in every single corner, switching back and forth over each other. The track boasts 30 start gates. So plenty of room for people to be playing online, and of course is completely free through MXB mods, and you can find the link for it down in the description below. I will be riding the Suzuki 450 today just for a little bit of fun, something a little bit different, and I hope you enjoy the video. Rightio, let's see what this is all about then. So to start things off, in terms of the whole private track feel, it does look very secluded. You know, it's by itself, it's amongst the foliage. We've just got the one, I guess, little like a garage here. We've got the one trailer, we've got the one van. Also, little shout out to the ASN, the All-Star Nationals over there as well. Love to see that promoting his own series. Nothing too much going on inside the garage. You've got the water truck as well. And then let's just see where things go. So I will throw out there that I have played, I think, one TC soundtrack before in the past, and I don't say this lightly because, as you know, I really, really enjoy soundtracks on this game. It may be one of the most fun soundtracks to play and just spin lap after lap after lap. And if you are unsure what track that is, if you go to the MXB shop, you can also search this as well. It is part of a track that is called The Warehouse. Now, this track, I believe, is now free. I think it used to be paid and then became free after a while. And what The Warehouse is a... I mean, that's quite self-descriptive. It is a warehouse which contains an arena cross track. However, then on the outskirts of that, you have a tiny little freeride area. You've got an enduro course, and then you've also got a small sand track. Now, this small sand track feels very similar to this in regards to how it looks, its appearance. In terms of feel so far, it feels very similar also. It's been out for a while now. It's not one that I ever see because I don't know how you'd go about putting it onto Deddy servers as such, if it is even possible. But I have spun numerous laps around there myself. I remember playing with Charlie around there as well when he was first learning the game. Very, very fun, very flowy, and not easy. Also, quite technical. You've got to try and work out what the fast lines are. There's a lot of lines that, you know, start inside, drift out wide, or you can start outside, cut back across over the rut and cut to the inside as you exit onto the next straight. So there's a lot of, I guess, experimenting, trial and error with lines to see what is fastest and what isn't. And I suppose the whole goal, as with any soundtrack, is to try and keep your wheels on the ground as much as you possibly can, keeping that bike moving forwards, rather than essentially bouncing off of the bumps and the bike going up in the air. So I'm hoping for more of the same of that on a bigger scale for this track right here. Now, Typical Canadian has given us basically no information to go with this at all. I'm not sure if he's written about it anywhere else in any sorts of discords, etc. I've saw no teasers for this. This has just been released on MXB mods as of the 1st of July. You'll probably see this on the 2nd, to be fair. I'm trying to get ahead of the game on the content creation side of things and just trying to really take it as seriously as I can do. And I apologize for taking a day off there, boys, and well, obviously a lot more than one day of no videos. The whole Donativon just consumed my life. You know, it was 12 hours a day, every single day, just non-stop. And I guess I'm finally free now, if that makes sense. Kind of bittersweet. It's one of them things that you want to keep going for as long as you can, but now it's finally done. We can get back onto the video creation side of things. And it's also opened my eyes in some aspects as well. So I think it's almost given me a bit of a kick up the bum and a bit more motivation, say that, like, you can do the streaming every day thing. So once I come back from being away, I'm going to go away for a couple of days just for family stuff, going back home, essentially. And I'll be back on Friday for Aerial at Southwick, which is the whole reason why I was excited to download this, to get a little bit of sand practice in as well for Southwick. But I'll be back. I'll be streaming Southwick over the weekend. Again, I might take a little bit of time off because the last two weekends have literally been spent playing MX Bikes basically all day for the Donatathons. Spend a bit of time with Linda, take her out, maybe go out for a nice meal, somewhere to eat, actually have a date, which we haven't done in God knows how long. But then after that, back on it. I plan on going over to the Twitch side of things because I don't want to play MX Bikes all day every single day. I think that will be a quick recipe to burning myself out and maybe not enjoying the game as much as I do right now. So I will play other stuff. I'm open to recommendations. It can be game playthroughs for things that I've never played before. It can be just random stuff if it's, you know, Minecraft, Elden Ring, God knows what people like seeing these days. I could even try and dabble in the Fortnite grind, you know. I think I played Fortnite once on a stream on this channel before, and it actually went okay. It went a lot better than expected. But yeah, I'm going to try and stream during the days on Twitch. I'm aware that that probably doesn't match up with all of your schedules, depending on where you're from in the world. But it will still be nice to have some of the evenings free as well to do normal MX Bike streams on the YouTube side of things, races, etc. I think that's the way it's going to go. So that is what I'm looking to do starting from next week. So keep your eyes out on that. It is just LinzMX on Twitch as well, if you do not follow me over there already. I'm always seeing people follow me on Twitch. You know, when I've got my OBS here on my other monitor, and I always see like notifications scrolling through, and I do still get Twitch followers on there, which is quite cool, considering it's something that I never really plug at all or don't spend too much time doing. So yeah, go give it a follow. Now let's swing back to the topic of Southwick. So, you know, Aerial is always following the week after a real life event now, so we can sit and talk about the real life event and then how I think the track is going to play out in game once it's all created and released. I'll be honest, can't remember much of the real life event. If you was in my stream during the when the race was going on, we decided to make a drinking game. We decided that every time the word sand was said on the broadcast, we would take a shot. What a silly idea that was. I think there was something like 5 shots within like the couple window period before the gate had even dropped. There was like another 5 in 250 Moto 1, and then after that, I couldn't tell you what happened after that. Honestly, I am not a big drinker. I don't drink loads. I maybe on special occasions, if it's like parties, you know, Christmas, etc. Other than that, I don't do much drinking. So consider me a lightweight.
I can't play the game, boys. I can't play the game. I'm finished.
Bruv, the way you're holding the controller right now has given me the ick. Honestly, stop.
it just feels right.
So me and Linda, because she decided to join in on the fun as well, we finished an entire bottle of rum. Charlie then decided to order a bottle of apple sours to our house, and I thought, oh, that'd be nice, you know, a little bit refreshing. That's a little bit different from the heavy rum. But no, my face was screwed up tighter than an it was ridiculous. So I had fun in the moment, lots of laughing, completely finished. It seems like everyone else really enjoyed it as well during the stream. And then the next day, I did not enjoy it as much. I was trying to get as many carbs inside my system as possible to just try and recover. We're all good now, but my God, maybe like a once a year thing. I have no idea. But one thing that was quite fun and interesting was doing a watch along, which is something that I might not do every week, because sometimes, you know, it's quite nice just to sit like in your chair, like slouch back and just shut up for a few minutes and just sit and watch some good motocross and see how it unfolds without having to try and be entertaining on the sides. But every now and then, you know, I might throw a stream up and we'll do a little bit of a watch party. The whole, I guess, concept of the last one was I threw the live timing up on screen as well as the chat so everyone can see what everyone's saying. And we just, almost as if you just like sat there with your buddies, giving it a watch and discussing it all as well. And Southwick was good, you know, actually decent racing. But some of the races this year, I'll admit, they've been a little bit of a snooze fest at times, with like Deegan dominating in 250s. 450s, I think, has been a little bit more exciting, you know, with Jet finally showing some weaknesses. It was nice to see Chase finally like get a win the hard way, if that makes sense. It feels like he fully finally earned this one, which I think is a crazy thing to say considering he came from dead last at Hangtown. But now it's finally like, okay, you have beaten Jet straight up with no, like, let's say, asterisks next to it, if that makes sense. So hopefully I'm wording that okay. And I like Jet, I like chase, I like Hunter, so I really don't mind who wins, but I just like their seeing, I like seeing actual battles. So I guess now the subject goes to, will Hunter keep the red plate through Redbud? That'll be interesting to see, and I'm interested to see your guys' thoughts on that as well. If I had to give my predictions for end of season, I still think that Jet comes back through and wins overall. I think Hunter will come second because he will beat Chase in terms of consistency over the remaining rounds. That is my fault. So I just think it will be Jet, Hunter, Sexton for first, second, or third for the end of the year. At 250, I feel like unless something really bad happens to Hayden, I think he's easily got this in the bag. The boy is getting overall after overall after overall and just gaining points each and every week. I don't really think he has much of a weakness at this point. A little bit disappointed because people like Vial, I think JT said it on the broadcast, where it's like, if this is your race where you are meant to win, you are meant to win, and he couldn't get it done. So I think that's it for the rest of the season now. I think everybody else is screwed. I would love to see someone like Hymus do well again. I don't know why, I've just kind of taken a liking to him. And yeah, hopefully we get maybe another couple, like a moto here and there, that somebody else manages to get a win, take a little bit of glory. It was really cool seeing Masterpool at High Point, obviously getting his win as well, which I do feel bad for Ty also. I feel like his win was almost overshadowed by the Pro Circuit 300. But no, I like Ty. He's had an interesting career so far in terms of the path he's taken, but I'm glad that he is on a good team now and is actually showing his potential. And then the final thing to talk about is, I don't know what happened to Mr. Max Anstey. You know, in Moto1, obviously, bike issues, but I'll be honest, I don't know what happened in Moto2 because, again, I may have been under the influence of some alcohol, but I'll have to go back and rewatch it all. Just a bit disappointing. You know, as a Brit rider, you want to see the British people do as well as they can do. And then in terms of seeing Southwick in game, I think we're going to see a level of roughness similar to what I'm playing on here by TC. I don't think it's going to be anywhere near as outrageous as like Lommel was in the GP season that JV and Hell Machine created there. I think it's going to be a lot more, I think it's going to just be more shallow, the rough, because watching the broadcast back from what I can remember, it wasn't crazy deep. The track was still very, very quick. I almost want to say it felt one-lined in places. Like, there wasn't a whole lot of room for passing by the looks of it. But that seems to be the general vibe in sand anyway, is you've got your one, I guess, smoothish berm that kind of starts from the inside, drifts all the way out wide, and it's going to be an interesting race to see in-game. And if you were to practice it, because I've seen a few people, especially over the Donate-a-thon, asking, can we do, like, last year's Southwick, etc. I don't know if it's worth grinding that track to practice for this one that we're going to get. I just don't think the two are going to be relatable in any means. Of course, riding sand and practicing on sand will be better than not riding and practicing on sand, just from a like traction perspective. You know, you can't lean the bike over as far on sand or get on the throttle quite as hard, or that back end will step around on you. But this feels right. This feels like something similar to what we would see and what we will get. I feel like Stone Rider might make Southwick a little bit rougher than what you're looking at on your screen right now. I would much rather sit and practice and ride around a track like this than last year's Southwick, for example, and I'd rather over prepare than under prepare. You might almost be better going and playing like this year's Lommel or last year's sand tracks, you know, like that's Sardinia made by JV, Lommel, the GP of Hyvinkä as well, so Finland. You're better off over-preparing than under-preparing. So throw yourself into the proper rough stuff, and then if the track is smoother and easier, that's a W, instead of going to a much, much smoother track and then finding out, oh, actually, this track is incredibly brutal and deep and being under-prepared for it. Suspension is going to come into play. I really desperately need to work on a suspension because I'm still going to be sticking to the gas. It's kind of like my thing at the moment. It's the bike I feel most comfortable on. However, the little bit of sand riding I have done, I haven't felt great on it. And it's exactly the same suspension as I've been running for the rest of the season, which would make sense. You know, there's no way on earth you could get a suspension that feels good at like Hangtown with how smooth it was, then also feels good at Thunder Valley with how choppy and big the bumps were, then also feels as good around High Point with how skinny, narrow and deep the ruts were there, and then would also feel good around a sand track. You know, it's not feasible. You need to mix things up a little bit. Usually I wouldn't rely on suspension too much, but I'm well aware I'm not the fastest guy on the gate these days, so I need a little bit of help. I need the bike to feel as good as it can do, and I need it to be able to really tank and absorb those bumps. And I think it's the front end mostly. I find that if I try slamming that front end into a sand corner too hard, it will just like collapse underneath me. So that's something that I want to work upon on that ready for Friday. I'm excited for it. I'm hoping it goes really, really well, and I'll probably end up spinning a good another handful of laps around this track in preparation for it. I would encourage those of you who are competing to do the same. You know, again, this might be slightly on the easier side than what we get, but it's a good base. It's a good place to start with, and then you can try and toss the bikes around some harder tracks, you know, like the Le Mans and Sardinia, tracks like that. But I like this. This is really nice. It's got a good flow to it, and it is kind of scratching that same itch that his soundtrack on his track The Warehouse had for me as well. Also, again, feel free to go and play that. It's on the shop, but it is free, so you can go and download it and give it a go. And other than that, I think the track looks nice. It does feel like kind of private-ish. The orange like fencing around the outside, it looks okay, but you can see, I don't know how well you can see on YouTube, the way this game works it, with how it loads in as you get closer, it almost looks like the fencing's moving at all times. That's kind of the only thing that's distracting for me. It almost look, I don't know if ugly is the right word, but there's some things in the game that kind of work better in reality than what they would, how you expect them to work. That's the only thing I can nitpick, really, is the way that the game loads the fences in. I don't know what else he would do for it to be like a private track as such. I mean, we've got like tires on the insides of corners, which is usually the sign of a good private track. Maybe the occasional like acerbis stake marker somewhere. But yeah, I think the fencing might be killing it a little bit for me. Other than that, track rides really, really well. There's at least two lines in every single corner, so you're not just locked into the one line. You can switch up if you need to. And in terms of like raceability online, I think I think there was something like 20 gates just from when I started. It looked like the start gates, there wasn't that many. If we go back and we go into replay real quick, we can go and have a little look over at that. So where was the start gates? They were over here. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So there's 30 gates. So actually a lot of people you can get riding around here. And I think the track would erode quite nicely. TC does have a knack for the soil types and messing around with the soil. I think his tracks erode really, really nicely. And having a look at it, I think the erode will be easy to see. It looks like it gets slightly darker. So the lighter the dirt, the higher up it is, the darker the dirt, the lower it gets. So very easy to see. So job well done there as well. So if you are preparing for Southwick, definitely give this one a go. It couldn't have released at a better time, really, just in preparation. We've got a couple days now to really practice and get the sand setup styled in. So well done, TC. Thank you very much for this. And again, not much more information given on the post. It was just pictures of the track and the track was released. So no idea how long it took, any like thanks or anything like that, if there's anybody in particular. Maybe he was busy, maybe he didn't have time. I know that MXB Mods is having a bit of issue at the moment with posts being submitted, so I don't know if that has come into play also. But that'll do it for me. I'm going to wrap it up there. I hope you have enjoyed this video. If you did, please do drop a little like and subscribe to the channel if you're new. It's greatly appreciated. And leave a comment on your thoughts if you enjoy the track, anything you'd change about it as well. Do you think it's rough enough? Does it need more roughness? So on and so forth. And does it fit the private track feel, as he has just called it? So that'll do it for me. Have a lovely rest of the day, whatever you're up to. I'll catch you all in the next video. Peace. Lin's in the zone, never backing down. Riding MX bikes, he's the tour for the title 2022 champ with a YouTube crown. His game is tight, no signs of slowing down. Late nights, bright lights, he's chasing that fame in the digital arena. Writing his name, she's a 10 out of 10. Support his lane, hairline might recede, but his passion's the same.